Elena, Veronica, these are for you.
Oh, Mark, thank you. Thank you, my love.
For the better future.
Finally, I finished the paperwork for my latest solved case. The rest of the evening is all about soft classical music and relaxing. I don't believe my luck. What do you want now, Duke? Hey, partner. It better be important, or...
I know it's your day off, and I'm sorry to bother you, partner. But I have a drowning victim that looks... ominous. More than usual. It's a murder, or an accident. I need your expertise to help me with this one.
An ominous-looking drownee? All right. But after this, we're even.
I knew you wouldn't let me down. I've sent a driver for you. See you there.
Driver is already here? That could only mean... Ugh! Duke sent the driver before he even asked me for help. That's awfully presumptuous. Great. No time to waste, then.
Good evening, Detective. Here, Detective Duke said you'll need the case file.
Thank you, Officer. Let's see what's the case.
Thank you.
What if the two accidents are connected?
Well, we've arrived, Detective.
Partner, over here. Thank you for coming, partner. The body is already bagged, but you can still investigate and use anything you need from the ambulance. Also, you can inspect the spot where the body was found. Here, it's pretty dark out there.
No! My beautiful Veronica! My daughter!
Now, Mr. Gore, please calm down. You shouldn't be here.
Yes, of course. I'm sorry, but my beautiful daughter!
I'll take him to the hospital. Let's go to Elena, Mr. Gore. She needs you now.
It's poison. To take a look at the evidence I've collected. Veronica obviously knew Mark and Elena, but was she on the yacht with them? The time of Veronica's death and the SOS signal from the yacht don't match. Also, the poisonous marks around Veronica's lips points to a murder case. I should visit and interrogate Mark and Elena at the General Hospital. Please, officer, to the General Hospital. What's going on in here? Where's Elena?
I'll kill her! Get out of my way! Let me go!
Calm down, Mark. I can't let you near Elena.
Ugh. Nobody knocks down my partner.
Get out of my way! Let me go! Ugh.
Duke, the cuffs! Quickly!
Get out of my way! Let me go!
Oh, nice and easy, Detective. Here, that angry man dropped this. Detective Duke went after him. And yes, Elena is locked in her room just to the right. The key is behind the receptionist desk.
Great. No time to waste, then.
I'll need to see another patient, but I'll check on Elena later.
Thank you.
Oh no. Help. Doctor, quickly.
She's in V-fib. Quick, detective, bring me the epi-kit. Hurry.
What?
In the supply room, the red metal case with the syringe sign on it. The key card is in my pocket. Bravo, detective. Now, hand me the sterile gauze. Injection now. Quickly, the EpiPen. She's breathing. Excellent. The oxygen mask? That's it. Breathe, Elena. Breathe. She's stable. For now. It seems that Elena has been poisoned, but I can't tell the toxin.
I found this toxin in her DNA.
How can we know it's the same one?
My bag. The lipstick.
I'll check it out.
Doctor?
Elena, don't worry. Our good police detective will keep you safe.
Police? Oh no. Veronica, is she dead?
I'm afraid so. The investigation is in progress. I'd like to ask you a few questions if you don't mind. It would help me.
I'll do what I can.
Thank you.
scared of you. Mark adored Veronica, but her and me, we were all right. But after our mother passed away, we got close. Still, Veronica never liked our father. Stan, she called him. Never dad, never father. Mark was making a new round of cocktails in the bar when Veronica went on the deck to catch some fresh air. Suddenly, something exploded. Fire, smoke. It was awful. I must have passed out because I don't remember anything else. I'm not in the mood for this now. That's in the past. I was in love with Mark. I'm not anymore. That's Mark's office. We used to meet there. We weren't doing anything bad. Just talking. Yes, a special line of lipstick which Mark made as a present especially for Veronica and me. Mark insisted that we wear it tonight.
Thank you, Elena.
It's the same poison. I've got the antidote. She'll be all right, but she needs to rest.
All right, Doctor. Take good care of her. I should take a look at the evidence I've collected. Elena isn't telling me everything, but someone did try to kill her. The poisoned lipstick points nicely to Mark, who owns a makeup factory. Still, his motive isn't clear. A secret love letter can lead to jealousy or revenge, but it seems too weak for my taste. I should visit Mark's office to check for more leads before I can determine his guilt in this murder case. Officer, quickly, take me to this address.
Well, we've arrived, Detective.
Officer, please hand me the surveillance kit.
Oh. Here you go.
That was close. What happened here? Let's see what the clues can tell me. Someone breaks the vent lid. He enters the room, leaving a muddy footprint. He's inspecting the desk when the dog attacks and wounds him. He falls and breaks the lamp. The burglar bandages his wound. Then he opens the lockers. Looks behind the painting and finds the safe. But he hears me coming. He gets away the same way he got in, knocking the chair down, leaving the camera behind. I wonder what's hidden inside the safe.
have one new message.
Veronica, my sweet love, if you're listening to this, she has probably eliminated me. Save yourself. Take the evidence we collected and show it to the police. They'll protect you from your family. I love you, Veronica. Forever.
That's interesting. Mark and Veronica had a secret voicemail number. Maybe that smartphone can provide me with the answers.
Zoom it, Veronica.
I won't take it anymore, no matter how much money you give me.
Easy now. Think of your beautiful two girls.
Who's that?
That's Stan Gore, Elena and Veronica's father. That changes everything. I should take a look at the evidence I've collected.
Veronica, my sweet love, if you're listening to this, she has probably eliminated me. Save yourself. Take the evidence we collected and show it to the police. They'll protect you from your family. I love you, Veronica. Forever.
I don't think that Mark had murdered Veronica, his love, with whom he investigated Stan and the unknown man on a gun trafficking charge. Still, who's she? And why is she a threat to Mark? Who's the burglar? And what's hidden on the disposable camera? Where is Stan Gore? This case is getting stranger by the minute. I need to see that warehouse. Then I'll present all the evidence to the chief of police. Please, officer, take me to the repository, Lane 28. Hey, partner. Did you track Mark down?
Mark went to meet Stan Gore at the warehouse on the...
repository, Lane 28.
How did you know? Wait, something's going on in there. I'm going in.
No! Duke, wait! Officer, call for backup.
No, there won't be any backup, Detective. You've discovered too much.
What do you mean? No. Water is rising. I need to calm down, breathe, stay calm if I want to get out. I'm coming, Duke. Thank you.
I'm coming, Duke.
Oh, detective. What are you doing here, soaking wet?
Doctor, is it really you? Please, I desperately need a ride to Repository Lane 28 or anywhere near it.
Anything for you, detective. Pop in.
You're a lifesaver. Thank you. So what brings you here?
Well, I'm off duty, so I borrowed the ambulance to run a small errand for a friend. I'm going back to the hospital.
Ambulance 45, return to the garage immediately. You're not supposed to...
Oh, seems like a storm is coming this way. A dangerous one. Luckily, I've picked you up just in time. And how about you, detective? How come you're hitchhiking near the Jumper's Cliff? I bet it has something to do with that girl who drowned herself. What's wrong, detective? You all right?
He's not telling the truth. Away from the hospital, not to it. And judging by the radio message, he stole the ambulance. Why is he lying? Also, he knows that Veronica is poisoned, not just a drownee. He's wearing gloves, which means he's about to get his hands dirty somehow. He obviously likes to gamble, but he has lost his watch recently. Is he in debt with some shifty guys who forced him to capture a certain her? Is it me he's after? Oh no. He'll probably attack me as soon as we stop.
We've arrived, Detective.
Tell us, where is the video? Speak and we'll stop.
I should take a look at the evidence I've collected.
Thank you.
Mark's no longer the suspect, but a possible victim. And judging by the note, I'm supposed to be captured as well. These criminals will stop at nothing. I need to get inside that warehouse and see who's behind all this, but I should be careful not to get captured.
Thank you.
Hi, guys. Looking for me?
Detective, you've got to help me. They want to rob me. They tied me and left me here when I didn't sign that order form. They murdered my Veronica. Please. Please.
Stan, I know that you were on that yacht. Tell me what happened there.
I didn't mean to hurt anybody. Oh.
Well, hello, Detective. Nighty night.
Thank you. Hello, kitchen staff.
Relax. I'll go downstairs and make us some.
Yes, I'm still here, sir.
Hola, kitchen lady. Two daiquiris, pronto.
You'll get your drinks with a little twist.
Here you go, sir.
Nice. Wait, I'll finish this. You can make me more.
Detective.
Elena? Where are we?
We're in our family mansion. They're keeping me held on the second floor. Be careful. The second guy went downstairs to the wine cellar.
But the kitchen is locked.
Check the calendar. Hurry!
Oh no.
You! Thank you.
It's me. Detective, come in. Quick, Detective. Let's tie him up before he wakes up. Then we can talk. Don't hurt her.
Shush, honey. Detective, we still have your precious Duke. So if we see any sign of the police, your Duke will be gone.
Let's see what the clues can tell me. Someone, probably Duke, was tied up to that chair. He was tortured. Then Duke's clothes were changed and he was removed from the room. Afterwards, the torturer used the chemistry set and made a poisonous drink. He gave it to Stan, who was tied up to the bed frame. Stan spit the drink out, but then he was forced to drink it up. The torturer then tried to break open the safe with the tools, but he was interrupted. He left, leaving bloody shoes and overalls behind. I must open that safe before the torturer returns.
The time has come for me to confess my secrets, just in case something happens to me. The Gore Bank almost went bankrupt, but we were saved by a mysterious gentleman, Eleanor's new friend. Not without a price, of course. The gentleman helped us, but then used our bank as a front for his gun smuggling business. When I wanted to stop him, the gentleman threatened my family. Asked Veronica and Mark for help, and we acquired a video of the gentleman's involvement with illegal weapons. But the gentleman saw the camera. As a result, Veronica was poisoned, Eleanor was attacked, and Mark went missing. I gathered all the files concerning the gentleman's gun smuggling business and locked it in my bedroom safe. I hope the one who's watching this will use the files to help my family and to make sure that the gentleman receives his punishment for all the crimes he has committed.
Elena introduced a certain gentleman into the Gore family in order to save Stan's bank, but instead, the gentleman used Stan and his bank as a cover-up for gun trafficking. Elena and the gentleman are the main suspects now. I must get on that yacht and find Duke. Oh, no, you won't. Move! To the room on the right!
Thank you.
Oh, detective. You're like a bad memory. Never let go, huh?
Thank you.
Everything looks good. I'll check up on the prisoner.
Look.
Mighty glad to see you, partner. But we need to stop the yacht, fast. We can put them all to sleep, but to do that we'll need 2 sleeping gas tanks and 2 gas masks. You go and find it while I change my clothes with him. Great, but that's not all.
Thank you.
I should take a look at the evidence I've collected. Elena is innocent. The bad cop poisoned the lipsticks by the order of the gentleman. Their plan was to leave Stan without any heirs or help, so he'll turn to the gentleman, who's the real mastermind behind all this. I must stop him.
We can put them all to sleep, but to do that, we'll need 2 sleeping gas tanks and 2 gas masks.
Great.
But that's not all. We'll need a map of the yacht with the guard post marked and two walkie-talkies. You go to the engine room and switch the sleeping gas tanks with the air tanks. I'll go to the control room, and when they are all asleep, I'll shut down the engines and call the police.
Great. No time to waste, then.
I'm at my position. Hurry and change the tanks, but don't trigger any alarm. Bravo! They're all asleep. No, wait. The gentleman and Elena are wearing their gas masks. They're heading for the speedboat. Hurry, partner. I'll meet you there. It's over. The police are on their way. Elena, how can you be on his side when he murdered your sister and your father?
Shut up!
It's true, we have the evidence that the lipsticks were poisoned by his henchmen. Elena, you almost died from it.
Enough!
No! Duke! Please don't die. I can't live without you.
He'll be all right, Detective. Go and catch that lying murderer. I'll look after your partner here.
Leave me alone! I won't go to jail!
I knew you won't let him escape. Nice job, partner. I'll let you buy me a drink if you tell me all about it.
Oh, Duke.